Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 2. I'm the RPG Chick, and we're on the Normandy SR2, and just looking around and talking to everybody. So most likely this episode will be just talking to everybody and looking at everything, and possibly ending off with some codex entries and stuff like that. Let's talk to this Edie or Eddie or whatever.
What's this area of the ship?
This is the Combat Information Center. Here, the crew receives sensor data and coordinates gunnery and damage control efforts. While Normandy is flown from the bridge, during combat, the commanding officer issues orders from the CIC.
Okay, I'm guessing I can access her from multiple parts of the ship then, if I'm specifically asking her what's this part. I could probably go somewhere else and ask her what's the other part. How you doing down there? Controls examined. Where? What controls are we going to look at? Tech labs? All over there, okay. Is there something about examining controls? Maybe they're up here. Okay. Do we have access to a map, finally? We do! Oh, nice. And so Eddie's up there, too. Personal terminal. Normandy hologram. Research terminal, lab, briefing. Okay. Cool. Oh, this is only deck 2 also we're looking at. Nice to finally have a map. Tech labs. I'm guessing the tech labs will go through there. Yeah. Alright, let's go talk to Joker and see what else there is along the way. Controls. Down here? Oh, these controls. Unlock 15 Mass Effect. Okay. We're never gonna get done reading this codex. Oh, nice. Where we exit, if you weren't currently flying around. Nice. That's awesome. I wish I had a better view of everything.
Can you believe this, Commander? It's my baby! Better than new! It fits me like a glove!
See that?
And leather seats! Military may set the hardware standard, but on a first-gen frigate, they could care less if the seats breathe. Civilian sector comfort by design.
Reproduction is not intended to be perfect, Mr. Moreau. Seamless improvements were made.
And there's the downside. I liked the Normandy when she was beautiful and quiet. Now she's got this thing I don't want to talk about. It's like ship cancer.
Ship cancer? Sorry, guys. I was probably loud. I think this is too good to be true.
I don't trust them. We still need to move ahead, but it's all too convenient.
Maybe you're right. I guess it's hard to argue when they install an AI to spy on us.
Look at this hat.
We're staying, though, right? I mean, the seat is real leather.
Good to see you're keeping it all in perspective, Joker.
Leather.
Leather. Look at his SR2 cap, too.
Yes, Shepard.
I want to talk about you. Edie?
I want to know more about you.
Eddie?
Do you have a specific inquiry?
What's your name?
Why are you named Edie?
Edie.
Edie is the phonetic pronunciation of E-D-I. That is an acronym for Enhanced Defense Intelligence.
Hmm. What is your location?
Where are you?
My core intelligence is housed in a quantum blue box located behind the medical bay.
What's your job?
What do you do aboard the ship?
I operate the ship's electronic and cyber warfare suites in combat. My reaction time is much faster than any organic. I collate the records of shipboard monitoring devices for the elusive man. I serve additional functions which are restricted at this time.
Additional functions?
Restricted functions? Like what?
I do not know. Some of my databases are sealed, some of my hardware is kept offline. I assume that when certain unknown conditions are met, those functions will be released to me.
Very interesting. Looking forward to finding out what those functions are. So cyber warfare, huh?
Cyber warfare means things like viruses, right?
In close-range ship-to-ship combat, I can sometimes break through the firewalls of an enemy's internal wireless network. Huh. Once I seize control of their systems, I can turn off gravity or air. I can disable weapons guidance or shields, or I can put their fusion plant in meltdown. On the defense, I manage Normandy's own suite of jammers, decoys, and internal firewalls.
That's pretty damn impressive, I have to say.
Sounds incredibly useful. Why isn't there someone like that on every warship?
Expensive. An organic operator cannot react quickly enough to changing circumstances or perform the necessary multitasking. This is a role that can only be filled by an artificial intelligence. Unfortunately, we are suspect.
Well, it might have something to do with how an AI almost destroyed galactic civilization, just putting it out there.
Man, Joker is better than ever. Monitoring device. What monitoring devices?
The elusive man has monitoring devices on board?
He has invested most of Cerberus's resources into the design and construction of this ship. He has an interest in monitoring our progress.
Alright, I want to talk about something else.
Let's discuss something else.
Ready.
What is this room?
What's this area of the ship?
This is the bridge, where the navigator plots our FTL vectors, and the helmsman maneuvers the ship.
Yeah, sitting right here, thanks.
Tell me about Cerberus.
I want to know more about the people I'm working with.
Much of that data is classified. Do you have a specific inquiry?
Yeah, what are their resources?
What sort of resources does Cerberus have? Money, personnel, facilities?
I have a block that prevents me from answering that question.
Huh. A block?
What do you mean?
Although I am less controlled than other AI, I am still subject to behavioral blocks and the physical isolation of my hardware. In this case, I am prevented from truthfully answering your question by Cerberus's levels of secret classification.
Huh. What's the structure of Cerberus?
How is Cerberus organized? Aside from the elusive man, I don't see much chain of command.
Cerberus is organized into task-oriented cells. Each operates in isolation. Members from one cell cannot recognize the members of another. Each cell's agents are led by a single operator. We are called the Lazarus Cell, which is directed by Operator Lawson.
Yeah. Which is Miranda, correct? How many cells are there? We're a cell, and we can run across other operatives and not know they're operatives, then.
So how many operations is Cerberus running right now?
I have a block that prevents me from answering that question.
How did they build a Normandy?
How did Cerberus replicate the most advanced warship in the Alliance Navy without anyone knowing?
I have a block that prevents me from answering that question.
Oh, brother.
Let's discuss something else.
Ready.
Actually, I'm done then. Goodbye.
That's all for now.
Logging you out, Shepard.
I'll log you out.
Commander.
How do you feel about the mission?
So, how do you think we're doing?
Well, the Normandy's not as ready as she could be. There's always more we could upgrade. And as for the crew, you'd have to ask a people person.
How's the squad?
What do you think about the people we're picking up?
Well, about the ones you went out with last. I would never say anything against Miranda and expect to survive the reprisal. Jacob is way too nice a guy for the number of ways he knows how to kill people. Right? It's just my opinion, though. There's really no need to go spreading it around.
God, Joker. Thinking about the good old days.
Ever think about the old Normandy and the trouble we got up to?
Yeah, those seem like the good old days now, but come on, it was hell at the time. Geth, Saren, Sovereign, and then we got dumped. We're stuck in a weird place, sure, but back then it wasn't all sunshine and bunnies.
What about the old crew?
What happened to the rest of the old crew? I heard most survived.
Almost did. Presley didn't. The rest of us just sort of drifted apart. The Alliance didn't care. I don't think they liked all the non-humans in your crew. We were your team, Commander. With the Normandy destroyed and you gone, there wasn't much keeping us together.
We gotta get the crew back together, definitely. I missed them already. How are things in the cockpit?
I assume everything's going well up here?
I really want a chance to put the Normandy through her paces. I just have to trim up the drive output and it'll be like we never lost her.
Safety standards advise against manipulating drive settings while engines are powered and in use, Mr. Moreau.
Commander, can we shut this thing off? I don't need it in my day-to-day.
It's got a mute? Fine. I didn't know that. It's got a mute. They'll use it.
If you don't want to hear it, turn the damn sound off.
Well, it doesn't change anything. It's still watching. Like some creepy kid staring at the back of your head in comp side. You just want to punch him, but he's special and he sets fires or something. Okay, a little too far there, but you know what I mean.
Your problem, yeah. Not mine.
Thanks. I'll remember this.
That's it for now.
See you, Commander.
Yeah, see ya. I remember his old farewell greeting. Yeah, see ya. Okay, so I guess we're ready to go down to another level. Or through these doors, either one. Oh, this was to the communication combat information center. Oh.
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
Oh, brother, I'm trying to go in there. Thanks, Kelly. Kelly, you lied. Wait. Kelly! Keep it up, I'll fire you. Oh, this is the elevator. I thought this went back. Okay, we check back here then. Oh, armory now. Okay. Eviscerator shotgun. Look at that. Shuriken machine pistol. Two options. M23 Katana shotgun. Common military shotgun. Deadly at short range, but ineffective at long range. Very effective against shields and biotic barriers, but weak against armor. Manufactured by Ariake Technologies, the Katana is a common mercenary weapon, is also popular on colonies with Varan infestations. Remember them? Shuriken machine pistol. A common but effective submachine gun. Fires 3-round bursts and can be pulsed for a higher rate of fire at the expense of accuracy. Very effective against shields and biotic barriers. As kinetic barriers have grown in popularity, so has the popularity of submachine guns. Manufactured by the Elkos Combine, the Shuriken machine pistol has a reputation for being deadly and easy to use, but is weak against armor. You know, we're in the future. Why are we using these standard pistols? Shouldn't we be using lasers or some kind of particle beam weapon or something? M3 Predator Heavy Pistol. Reliable, accurate sidearm, effective against armor. Weak against shields and biotic barriers. Manufactured by the Alanis Risk Control, the Predator is valued as a powerful, deadly, and relatively inexpensive weapon. While it is not generally employed in the military, where kinetic barriers are common, it's still very popular in Terminus systems where these defense are less common. And then the grenade launcher. M100 grenade launcher. Rapid fire grenade launcher, favored by Blood Pack of Vorka mercenaries, capable of taking down multiple enemies with a single well-placed shot, effective against armor, shields, and biotic barriers. M22 Eviscerator Shotgun. The Liebershaft 2180 shotgun or eviscerator is of human civilian design and has a unique ammunition generator. Where most modern firearms shave off chips or pellets from an ammunition block, the M22 shaves off serrated metal wedges designed to fly aerodynamically. This dramatically improves its armor-piercing capabilities, and its tight grouping helps wound ballistics and at longer ranges than standard shotguns. This design also violates several intergalactic weapons treaties, so the M22 is not distributed to military. Alright, so if we were working for the Alliance, we wouldn't be allowed to use this thing, in other words. M4 Shuriken machine pistol. A common but effective submachine gun fires 3 rounds per... Oh. Did I read this already? Yes, I did. Alright. We can talk to Edie here, too.
What's this area of the ship?
This is the armory, where small arms are maintained and upgraded. Using Omnitool, computer-aided design, and manufacturing, we have the capability to manufacture several new models.
Manufacturing, huh? Hey, Jacob.
Commander, there hasn't been time to really settle in and take stock. I want to say that working with you is a great opportunity to do something that matters. It's a privilege to serve on the Normandy, Commander.
It's a risky assignment.
You may change your tune if we end up like the original Normandy.
Right.
Maybe. As long as the elusive man walks his talk, and you do the same, I'll do my best to make sure we succeed. That's been the condition for my service so far. I have issues with certain actions Cerberus has taken in the past.
Talking the talk and walking the walk? What about these actions?
What has Cerberus done to make you nervous?
A lot. They've been called terrorists, and with good reason. Doubt you can find a more checkered past. But if the Collector threat is real, and we do something about it, Cerberus will be remembered differently. Or we'll all be tried and executed. Can't count on people thinking about it as hard as I have.
Well, I'm glad to have you aboard.
I look forward to working with you, Mr. Taylor.
Likewise, Commander. Let me know if you need anything.
At ease, soldier. Paragon? I guess because we were nice to him. Things opening before we even go right near them. Oh, nice. Is that the warp core? Or whatever they call it on this ship? It's down there. Don't want any warp core breach, you know what I'm saying? Okay, let's go this way. Briefing comm room, alright.
What's this area of the ship?
This is the FTL communications room. In addition to interfacing with the FTL comm network, Normandy is fitted with a quantum entanglement communicator linked to the elusive man's office. This allows lag-free communication even when you operate off the comm grid.
Quantum what?
I've never heard of a quantum entanglement communicator. How does it work?
Essentially, two subatomic particles are created in an entangled state. One is installed here, and the other in the elusive man's office. When one particle occupies a given quantum state, its entangled partner will always enter the opposite state, no matter the distance between them. If we alter the state of our particle, that alters the state of the elusive man's. This allows us to send data in the form of quantum bits.
That sounds pretty fascinating and useful.
Why aren't these used everywhere?
Each quantum pair costs nearly as much as a comm relay, and can pass only one quantum bit of data at a time. In addition to the cost and bandwidth issues, the system is strictly point-to-point. To contact 100 different worlds, we would need to manufacture and install 100 entangled pairs, one link to each world.
Alright, thanks.
That's all for now.
Logging you out, Shepard.
Mm-hmm. Oh my. Alright, okay. Let's go out. The weapons, alright, this way. Tech labs.
A scientist is required to use the technical laboratory. A scientist is required to use the technical laboratory.
It's my ship, I can go wherever the hell I want, excuse me.
No messages for you, Commander.
Thank you.
A scientist is required to use the technical laboratory.
Fine, fine. Oh, wow. We're here, deck 2. Okay, let's go to my captain's cabin. That's where I came from. You get this whole deck just for this. I guess another craft to the side. You here in my quarters too?
What's this area of the ship?
This is the commanding officer's quarters.
It's larger than the quarters of other warships I've served on.
This is a Cerberus vessel, not an Alliance warship. Accommodations have been made for personal taste. That said, this space is directly under the exterior pressure hull. The fitting yard workers called it the loft.
Do I want to be right underneath the exterior pressure hull? We got music, we got fish. Oh. Ahaha. Nice. Yeah, they... Oh, wait. Oh, okay. So I can customize this stuff. There's the sentry interface. Oh, there's the umbra visor we were talking about. I don't want her face covered all the time. I mean, this might be better armor, but I really don't want her face covered all the time. And with all four of them, that's what happens. You can kind of see her face through there, but... Let's give her the sentry interface. That's it. This visor works with the Sentry System, a software application that optimizes an armor suit's microframe computer. When the Sentry System is running, more power can be devoted to shield management. Umbra Visor, a next-generation night vision device that assists targeting by detecting the focal point of the wearer's eyes and enhancing the image at that location. The visor helps direct a biotic power or a shot from an Omni tool directly where the vice, where the wearer is looking. Kind of stinky. We can't only choose that stuff from here or other stations. A hood issued to covert action teams. This model's optic display. Hope you can hear me. Interfaces with most small arms. Auto-targeting software linking hand and eye for improved accuracy and increased weapon damage. Ballistic mesh fabric and composite ceramic plating provide necessary armor, and the integral air filter helps in hostile environments. We just suddenly stopped. N7 breather helmet. Dual layer of fabric armor and kinetic padding within a lightweight ablative ceramic shell. Comes standard with suite of communication, navigation, and battlefield awareness software. Hard sealed to protect wearer from hazardous environmental conditions. This has some of that. N7 chest plate. Interlocking plates of thick ablative ceramic plates designed to be light, effective, and easily repaired. Shoulder guards. Curved shell of ablative ceramic over kinetic padding. Gauntlets. A combination of fabric armor with kinetic padding and blades of ablative ceramic for protection. And greaves. And there's more. Dual layer of fabric armor and kinetic padding thick plates of ablative ceramic and lined with additional kinetic barrier emitters. Oh, there's more stuff. I got to go like that. Okay. Material. Oh, cool. I can change all this crap. A little shiny tint. Oh wow. I didn't know I could do all this. Oh my. Way too pink. How about like a purplish? It's pretty cool. I like this, actually. Oh, there's more. To the highlights. That pattern? Those patterns? Pattern colors. Oh, can I customize my casual stuff too? Oh, there's only... Right, those four. Okay, never mind. New music. Dance! Down! Down with your bad self. Oh, nice! Huh. Yeah, what happened? Went away for a second. View achievements. Up here, I guess? Alright, so these are different. Return to active duty and save crew from overwhelming attack. Very elusive. Missing in action. Just another place to get to my terminal. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. Any more songs before I get out of here? Nice. Different versions of the Mass Effect. The first game. The themes from that game. I wonder how many different songs there are. We're very into the electronica stuff. Shepard here. Oh, I love this. This is from CSAC. Oh, they add this like sad tune to it though. That's awesome. Hehe, I like that. Anything else? I don't want to bore you guys. I'm sitting here listening to music. Combat theme. Oh my god. I don't know this song that well. Now if I leave, will this theme be playing when I come back in? That would be great. Cruise quarters. You know, there's a lot there. Let me just go to engineering first. Monitoring station. Look at that. Awesome. Turbines and stuff? Oh, we got no more codex. Barely listen to the ones we have. Port cargo hold. We have cargo hold? Because there's not going to be anything in it, right? Am I just headed there? Because it don't show us near port cargo hold. Did we come from this way or not? I don't know. Getting lost in my ship here. Engineer Daniels?
You came all the way down here to see us?
Of course.
You're speaking to our commanding officer.
They have interesting accents. Hello?
I'm touring the ship, getting to know my crew.
I'm Engineer Ken Donnelly, handling the power control systems. This is Gabby.
That's Engineer Gabriella Daniels, actually. I'm responsible for the propulsion systems.
What can we do for you, Commander?
Do you need anything?
Are you set up okay down here?
We can't complain. I just wish it didn't take so long to calibrate the FBA arrays.
Kenneth, you're complaining.
What's the issue, Kenneth? What's the frequency, Kenneth?
What kind of problems are you having?
When they upgraded the Normandy design, they got a bit sloppy with the FBA couplings. I won't bore you with the tech, but there's an array of attenuators in the primary power transfer system that channels the field bleed.
Kenneth, you're boring the commander with tech. In short, if
how do you
we
know
had
that?
T6 FBA couplings installed, it'd save us a lot of maintenance time each day.
So why don't you have them?
Why isn't something like that already installed?
It's probably just a design oversight. Efficiency isn't affected. It's a maintenance issue.
Also, the T6 model can be hard to find. Nash and Stellar Dynamics discontinued them.
We could probably find used ones in the Omega markets, but we have no time for shore leave.
Oh, we're supposed to be headed there anyway, to the Omega system. Well, the Omega cluster? I don't even know. What are your feelings about Cerberus?
What do you think about Cerberus?
Actually, we don't know much about the organization other than the Normandy team. We know our mission and who's in charge.
We're off to kick the collectors right in their daddy bags. That's enough for me.
In the daddy bags? I like this guy. He kind of reminds me of Scotty from Star Trek. Tell me about your training.
Where'd you receive your training?
Both Gabby and I started in the Alliance, serving on the SSV Perugia.
She flew in the first wave at the Battle of the Citadel. We saw Sovereign firsthand.
But you left the Alliance?
Why did you leave the Perugia?
After you died, Anderson lost political clout. The Council backslid on the Reaper menace.
They discounted Sovereign as an isolated threat, as a single...
Which was bullshit. They said your warnings of greater danger were mistaken or delusional.
We lost respect for Alliance leadership. We need to fight the real enemy, and only Cerberus seemed to be doing that.
Well, my next obvious question should be if you two are married, because you sure act like it. How did you join Cerberus, Ken?
How did you wind up with Cerberus, Ken?
Once you were gone, the Alliance brass descended like vultures, tearing apart everything you'd said. I was very public with my defense for you. I didn't hold back.
That's an understatement. If Kenneth wasn't such a talented engineer, they'd have court-martialed him for insubordination.
But it got me noticed by the elusive man. He made an offer, and here I am.
And what about you, Gabby?
So why did you join, Gabby?
Kenneth and I have been partners in crime since we graduated from Tech Academy. When he got the Cerberus offer, I insisted that it include me. He'd fall apart without me.
Thanks, Mum.
Also, I love engines, and the Normandy is state-of-the-art. When I got the opportunity to work on her, I had to jump.
All right, bye.
Carry on.
Will do, Commander.
She's a cutie.
I'm amazed Shepard came down to see us.
I told you she would.
So funny. These two are hilarious. I love them already. Oh, awesome. This is where you feel the power. Cool. I want to man this station. Mana station. Subdeck stairwell. Where's this go?
What's this area of the ship?
Normandy's cargo deck. It includes facilities to rearm and repair Normandy's embarked ground vehicle and shuttle.
My last ship didn't need a shuttle. Why do we have one?
This ship is nearly twice the mass of the previous Normandy.
Really?
It is more difficult to land the ship on high-gravity worlds.
We got a shuttle. I want to see the shuttle. But we're just going back up. We're back here. Oh, okay.
Access to this room is currently restricted.
This is my ship. This is the second room you've restricted me to. This is my damn ship. What the hell is the matter with this? Edie, you let me in there right now. I'll have you disassembled so fast. Can't get in here either. Holy crap. I guess I'm going back up because there's nothing here. Cruise quarters, last stop. Alright guys, I'm gonna actually call it an episode right here. The next episode, I don't know how much more we have to see around here, so I'm not sure. We might just read codex entries a lot, or have them read to us, either one or both. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.